Hi students, we have completed around 4 lectures in the thermodynamics. Okay, so if you have not seen any of them, if you are skipping at least one of them, this topic is not going to be understood by you. Okay, so if you skip first video, then second video will be problem. Second video, if you are skipping, third video will be a problem. Like that, before attending this fifth lecture of the thermodynamics, I hope that because of any reason, if you skipped any of the video, I think you will go through those videos. All 4 videos are very, very important and separately made. One is only for the heat, one is only for the work, one is only for the first law, one is only for the introduction. Okay? Introduction, I elevated you from the basics to the advanced level. So, directly studying the polytropic process is not a solution. Okay, so I think you have studied that. If not, please go through it. Okay, hi students, today we are here for the very important and interesting topic of the thermodynamics. It is somewhere studied in chemistry, somewhere studied in physics, somewhere studied in engineering. Okay, so it is a multi-useful topic, and the multi word is used in the heading itself. What is that heading? I think already you have seen the thumbnail, and whatever you get in the thumbnail, the same thing you are going to get in the lecture also. Okay, what is that? Polytropic process. Many people don't know what is the polytropic process, and they can't understand how the formulas came and where it is used. So here I am going to use it and explain from the very basic level. Very basic level. I will feel as if you are not knowing anything. You are at the beginning stage of the thermodynamics. Okay. So first of all, my way of teaching is first what it is and where it is used. If you know what and where, then it is easy. Okay. From where it came, that also we will explain. Okay. Polytropic process. So it is a thermodynamic process. Once we are studying about the thermodynamic, definitely which it is a thermodynamic process only, which obeys the relation. Like if a gas obeys the relation PV is equal to nRT, that gas is called as ideal gas. So likewise, any thermodynamic process which obeys PV to the power of N is equal to constant, that process is called as a polytropic process. Is it understood? Like if a gas follows PV equal to nRT, then it is called ideal gas. If a gas follows Van der Waals equation, it is called as a real gas equation. Likewise, a process, thermodynamic process, which follows this relation is called as a polytropic process. Okay, so this is what polytropic process. Now where it is used? It describes all multiple expansion, compression, which includes the heat transfer. Wherever heat transfer causes, if heat is going out, if it is compressed or expanded, and multiple, not in one single step. Poly means more than. Okay, so multiple expansion and compression, which includes the heat transfer, is explained, is described by the polytropic process. Is it understood? So the main formula, whenever you get polytropic, then the what should strike into your mind? PV is equal to constant. Okay, so PV to the power of N is equal to constant. What should be the constant? PV to the power of N is equal to constant. Is it understood, students? Where here what is P and what is V, everybody know, pressure and volume. But here N is not the thing which you are thinking. You are thinking as a number of moles or not? That's what I was also thinking, but it is not the answer. Here N is called as a polytropic index. What it is called as? Polytropic index. By changing the N value, I can change and apply it to the different process. Okay. Suppose if I take polytropic index as a zero, if I take polytropic index as a zero, then I am substituting P into whether V to the power of zero is equal to constant. That means V something to the power of zero is equal to zero. No, one. So P is equal to constant. So that means a process where pressure is maintained constant, a process where pressure is maintained constant, that normally we consider as what? Isobaric process. Okay, so poly means it also includes isobaric process. So isobaric process is also a polytropic process because it follows this equation when n is equal to 0. Okay, a polytropic process for which polytropic index is 0, then that polytropic process will become as isobaric process. Okay, otherwise a polytropic process which is carried out at constant pressure have polytropic index how much? 0. Now second, as a second condition, what I am going to take? N is equal to 1. Okay. So now what I will do? P into V to the power of 1 is equal to constant. Now both are constant, but what is this constant? Very simply, P, by using ideal gas equation, we can say this is equal to nRTr0. Here thermodynamic process, as I told you, thermodynamic process. So P into V is equal to constant. What is that constant? T is constant. Okay. So once PV is constant, means nRT is also constant. For 1 mole of gas, R is also constant. So T is constant. So that means that become as a isothermal process. Which process? Isothermal process. Okay. So the polytropic process which takes place at constant temperature is called as isothermal process. Otherwise, for isothermal process, polytropic index is how much? 1. So these are all covered under one heading. What is that one heading? Polytropic process. Now you got the right meaning of it or not? Now I will take another, I got total 4 conditions. How many conditions? 4 conditions, then all process will be covered here. Okay, so n is equal to 0, n is equal to 1. Now you have seen, now you are going to see the how much condition? Condition number 3. And condition number 3 is awesome. Condition number 3, I am taking awesome infinity. Okay, so what I will write? P V to the power of infinity is equal to what I will write? Constant. What I will write? Constant. Now this is the magic. I am going to do multiplying exponents or powers with 1 upon infinity. So P to the power of 1 upon infinity into V to the power of 1 upon infinity into infinity is equal to constant to the power of infinity. Sorry, 1 upon infinity. Is it understood? Or it is again going to be a constant. You do any damn thing with constant, constant will always be constant. Understood? Now because of this, what I am getting is P to the power of 1 upon infinity, something upon infinity, 0. So V to the power of 1 is equal to constant. So here ultimately what I am getting? V is constant. Okay. So all of you know this or not? Once a process where V is constant, that process is considered as very nice isothermal process. Okay. So how many process we have covered? We have covered isobaric process. Isobaric process polytropic index is equal to how much? 0. N is equal to 0. Here isothermal process polytropic index is equal to 1. And for isochoric process N is equal to infinity. Okay, vicinity, infinity. Then I am going to take the fourth condition. I am going to take what condition? Condition number four. Let us take gamma. Gamma you remembered or not? Cp upon Cv. Let us take anything 1.4. 1.44 is okay. So gamma. Is it understood? So then Pv to the power of gamma is also constant. Where it is applicable? This formula already we have studied or not? Very good. If you don't remember, go to the previous lecture. Okay. Type what you will type? Adiabatic. Which chem? Adiabatic process, which chem? Understood? You will get in the YouTube. You are already in the YouTube. In the YouTube, you will be search button. What you will write? Which chem? First, you will write which chem? Adiabatic. Okay? Then you will get that video. You will reach there. Otherwise, there is a special playlist made for the 2020 students. And in that also, you can go through all wonderful, excellent lectures. Sequentially, chronologically arranged for your benefit only. Okay, so PV to the power of gamma is equal to constant. This is applicable for irreversible adiabatic. Main problem is which batic? Adiabatic and isoenthalpic. Isoentropic. What is entropy? That we will study, but for the time being, what we will take? Isoentropic. Okay. Isoentropic process. Is it understood? So PV to the power of gamma is equal to constant. What is it is called as and how it is called as, that everything I told you, just go through it. Okay, just make a note of it. All four process, n is equal to 0, n is equal to 1, n is equal to infinity, n is equal to gamma. Okay. Okay, remembered what it is called as? PV to the power of gamma is called as, very good, Poisson's equation. Which equation? Equation. And they have given to you the wonderful table of gamma. What is Cp, what is Cv for monoatomic, for diatomic, for polyatomic, how to find out degree of freedom, F, Fr by 2, like that. Everything I have explained in that video. So I will think that you are going to read it once again, even though you are reading, but you are gone through, but not remembered. Okay. So I will also give the tabular form here also. N value. Okay. And type of process. Is it understood? So first N value I have taken, polytropic index. N value is equal to 0. Then what it will become as? Isobaric process. N value is equal to 1, then what it is? Isothermal process. Okay, N value is equal to infinity, isochoric process. What it is? Isochoric process. N value, what you want? N value is equal to gamma. Okay, then it is adiabatic. Okay, for time being adiabatic, after that you can also understand isoentropic. Is it understood? So there are certain formulas with respect to the PV to the power of, and it, here we are using only P and V, and temperature also will feel I have not introduced into the polytropic formula what happens to me, and there we want some relation between T and V also, we want some relation between T and P also. P temperature came to me and asking why you are not included polytropic process. I told, don't worry, I am going to introduce and give you a wonderful formula with your values also. Okay, poly, why it is poly and when it is what condition? I think all of you made a wonderful formula. Okay, so first formula, this can be converted into P1 into V1 to the power of N is equal to P2 V2 to the power of N. So first what we can write, cross multiply, what multiply you will cross multiply, P1 by P2 is equal to V2 by V1 to the power of N. This is the first formula. If it is mentioned that polytropic process and polytropic index is this much and volume is given that much, like that, for calculation, with respect to pressure and volume, you can use this. Okay. Now, what is my intention? My intention is to include the temperature so that you should be able to solve temperature-based numerical for polytropic process. Okay. Are you ready for that? Now, second. So, I am not going to use something new. Okay. So, P1 V1 to the power of n is equal to P2 V2 to the power of n. Okay. So, what I am going to do, I am going to multiply it with V1 to the power of n minus 1 and V2 to the power of n minus 1 this side. Okay. Why it is? Because PV is equal to nRT. Okay. So, once P into V is constant, I can multiply both on the both sides. Okay. As PV is equal to nRT. So, I want that PV term should come. For that problem only, I have multiplied this like this. Is it understood? So, this can be written as, otherwise what I will take, I will make you understand in the other direction. Okay. PV is equal to nRT. Otherwise, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Now it is okay. So, people are not able to understand with that method. So, immediately I can understand from your face feelings that you are not happy with that explanation. Okay. So, PV is equal to nRT for PV. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Okay. Now, what I will do what I want. Okay. But V1 to the power of n minus 1. Okay. And P2 into V2 into V2 to the power of n minus 1. What is this? Simply, it is n minus 1 multiplied both sides. Now, PV is equal to nRT, PV is equal to nRT. But only thing, number of moles, nRT1 into, see, V1 only I have written like this. V1 can be written as V1 to the power of n. Okay, because PV to the power of n is equal to constant. Is it understood? So, PV to the power of n only I have split like that. Okay, PV to the power of n, P1 V1 to the power of n is equal to P2 V2 to the power of n. So, V1 I have written as P1 V1 into V1 to the power of n minus 1. Is it okay? So, P2 V2 into V2 to the power of n minus 1. Okay? So, now I think you are comfortable with this because I can understand from your face feelings that you are comfortable. Okay? So, P1 V1 to the power of n is equal to P2 V2 to the power of n. So, P1 V1, I am taking one V this side. So, another V will be n minus 1. P2 into V2 into V2 to the power of n minus 1. Now, are you comfortable? Same thing I have written here. But my intention is in place of the PV is equal to nR. So, P1 V1 is equal to nRT1, P2 V2 is equal to nRT2. Don't get confused with this n and that n. Okay? So, I am going to remove that. Don't worry for that. Understood? So, here N1, P1 V1 I will write as a n, otherwise nRT1. Okay? Into V1 to the power of n minus 1, P2 V2, nRT2. Okay? Into V2 to the power of n minus 1. So, don't get confused. That's why immediately I am cancelling that. Okay. Now, I am getting a beautiful equation. V to the power of n minus 1 into T is equal to constant. Now, you are in a condition to solve the formulas when volume and temperature is given. If you want this type of formula, what we can write? V1 to the power of n minus 1 into T1 is equal to V2 to the power of n minus 1 into T2. Okay? Otherwise, if you want all T's together, V's together, you can make it or not? Okay, you can make it. So, what is the next formula? V1 cross multiplied. V1 by V2 to the power of n minus 1 is equal to T2 by T1 to the power of 1. Okay, so this is the final formula I am getting. Are you getting same thing? Very nice. If you are getting same thing, you are also bright and intelligent like me. Okay, so I don't want all this nonsense. I want only these two formulas to be written. Okay, so second formula I have derived is V to the power of n minus 1 into t is equal to constant. Otherwise, V1 by V2 to the power of n minus 1 is equal to T2 by T1 to the power of 1. Okay? Any doubt in this one? Check with it. Okay? T2 and T1. I don't think any doubt in this one. Okay? Now, I am able to accommodate volume and temperature. So, what will be the my next step? My next step is to include the temperature but not with pressure, volume. I am going to include volume, pressure. Okay? For that, I am making some arrangement. Okay? What is that arrangement? I will take P1 V1 to the power of n, P2 V2 to the power of n is main basic equation. But I know that V is equal to nRT by P. What I told you, my intention is to keep P. I don't want V. Already T and V relation we have. Okay? So here V1 is equal to T1 P1. Understood? And V2 is equal to nRT2 by P2. Is it understood? So P1 is already required, and in place of the V1, nRT1 by P1 to the power of n. In place of P2 as it is, P I want. In place of V2, nRT2 divided by P2 to the power of n. Chuck, chuck. Okay, here this is P1. If I take common, 1 minus n. Okay? Into, otherwise I will write like this. P1, 1 minus n into T1. P2, here 1 minus n, T2, to the power of n, to the power of n, is equal to constant. Okay? So, what is the formula we are getting now? P to the power of 1 minus n, T to the power of n, is equal to constant. Okay? So, when you want the formula in terms of, this I am going to erase, are you having any problem? No problem. Okay, third relation we got is P to the power of 1 minus n, T to the power of n is equal to constant. Okay, it looks awkward. We can modify it into T1 by T2 is equal to P1 by P2 to the power of 1 minus 1 upon n. How much? 1 minus 1 upon n is the next formula. Okay, so this is how we can find out the polytropic process, different formulas for the different condition. Okay, so polytropic is not a new formula, new thing. It is old thing but merged together. Okay, so like you are going for chemistry tuition somewhere, physics tuition somewhere and maths tuition somewhere, all comes together then become it as a coaching center. Okay. Likewise, adiabatic sum formula, isothermal sum formula, isochoric sum formula, isobaric formula, all together it is polytropic process. Okay? Now, I think you are comfortable or not. Now, at the finally, I am going to give you how to derive, how to calculate work done in any polytropic formula. Okay? So, just make a note of all these formulas so that I can start the next topic. Okay? Okay, here comes A to Z work done in a polytropic process. How to find out work done in a polytropic process? Okay, work done, simple formula. I told you, if you are not sure which formula to use, the best formula is integration PdV, otherwise P delta V. Okay, so here main problem is we wanted to differentiate with V, but problem is that there is no V. So, but I will bring V so that I can able to differentiate, because as we are saying that it is a polytropic process, So polytropic formula says that P into V to the power of n is equal to constant, where n is equal to number of moles. Is it correct? No, n is equal to PTI, polytropic index. Okay. So P is equal to constant to the power of V to the power of n. Okay. So some constant into one stage 1 to stage 2. Okay. State 1 to state 2. Here I will write 1 upon V to the power of n dV. Is it understood? So this can be written as minus constant V to the power of n minus 1, or minus n we can write. Okay. Constant, this we can write as 1 to 2 V to the power of minus n. Okay. So then dV. So it is simply minus n plus, I will write separately. Okay. So now it will become as minus constant integration, integration is not required. Okay. So V to the power of minus n plus 1 divided by minus n plus 1. Am I correct? Otherwise, if you want to, you can write it as a 1 minus also. Okay. Minus constant V to the power of 1 minus n. Now it looks more beautiful, I think. This one is for here. 1 minus n, and here also 1 minus n. And stage 1 to stage 2. That is V1 to V2. Okay. So if I substitute that minus constant, what I will get here? V2 to the power of 1 minus n, V1 to the power of 1 minus n divided by 1 minus n is common. Now I am going to make sure that pressure also should be there. So already I know that PV is equal to constant or not. So but here I will write P1 V1. Okay. So I am very tricky person. Minus I will keep it outside only. So here constant into V to the power of 1 minus n V2. I will write it here clearly. So up to here I have noted. Please make a note of it. This place I want. Okay. Now here minus constant is okay. Minus constant I will multiply inside. Okay. Constant into V2 to the power of 1 minus n minus constant into V1 to the power of 1 minus n divided by 1 minus n. Okay. Divided by what? 1 minus n. Constant into. Okay. Now see how I am technically strong. In place of this I will write P2 V2 into V to the power of 1 minus n. And in this place I will write P1 V1 into V to the power of 1 minus n by 1 minus n. Why I am all doing this? Because I don't want this values. Okay. I don't want this values. Sorry, V to the power of n. Here also n. So this n will get cancelled. My intention is very clear. My intention is very neat. So that I can give you the neat formula. Which formula? Neat. N-E-A-T. Neat formula. Okay. Don't misunderstand. Minus work done is equal to here only V will stand. P2 V2 minus P1 V1 divided by 1 minus n. And this is what the work done in a polytropic process. Work done in a polytropic process. What is n here? Polytropic index. Okay. Now you can convert it into the any other formulas. If temperature is given, all that you can do it or not. So there are in market hundreds of formulas. All mother of all market formulas are this one. How the mother came, I explained you. I think all of you understood. We have a nice session, wonderful session, clumsy session, and concentrated all topics together related to the polytropic we have discussed. I think this deserves a good like if not yet done, and share it to your friends. If you are new to this channel, subscribe for more wonderful such videos. See you, bye bye, with the next video. make a note of it.